That's affirmative.
Let's do this.
Heading there now. Got something over here.
Is this what the aliens do for fun? At least they're not playing computer games.
Moving to position. Okay. We're green to go.
On my way. Locked and loaded.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Yes, it almost looks like a larger version of the sectoid, but something is different. What is that energy? That alien is clearly different from the others. It's wielding a power unlike anything we've previously encountered.
Damn it, enemy is still alive.
Finally turning the tide. Now that we've captured their device, the aliens are running out of secrets.
It's imperative that we begin the research as soon as possible.
Now that we've captured this device, we should probably be expecting the aliens to pursue us more aggressively. I doubt losing it was part of their plan.
Doctor?
Don't you think a victory celebration is a bit premature at this juncture?
We just neutralized their central command. We've got no other alerts on the entire system, and we took out their leader. In my book, that's a win, Doctor.
I'm not the only one who understands this war isn't over yet. The existence of this artifact, which we believe to be a communication device of some kind, begs the question. If the sectoid commander was the alien leader, then who or what was it communicating with? I believe this is indeed the same creature we encountered when we made first contact with the aliens. As we have observed, it is somehow capable of using its mind as a weapon. If we were to study this specimen's brain tissue, perhaps we might be able to adapt this ability for our own purposes.
Commander.
Mission complete.
Generator complete.